All right, guys, so now we're going to take a look at the coxa bone, or the hip bone. And before I do that, I want to kind of give you the three different divisions of the coxa bone. So if you look here, we have the tape to kind of mark out the three different parts of it. So if you have to see the tape, it's separating these two bones right here. This one right here is the pubis. This one right here is the ischium. And then all this top one up here is the ilium. But we're going to take a closer look at each individual one, starting with the ilium. One of the first things I want to do is I want to try to show you guys the orientation of the ilium. So if you imagine I'm trying to hold this like a gun, and if my finger, that's the trigger finger. Where the trigger finger side is, that's the anterior side. Anything over here is the posterior side. Okay? So now let's go ahead and take a look at this bone and each individual portion, right? So if we look here, you have this little spine right there, a little bump right there. That's called the anterior inferior iliac spine. Then if I come up here, we have another spine. That's called the anterior superior iliac spine. Then I'm going to kind of move this all the way over here. This is the iliac crest. Then I'm going to scrape this surface right here. This is the iliac fossa. If I follow this all the way down, it's kind of like a, you can't really see it very well, but there's a line right here. And this is actually called the arcuate line, actually which helps to form the pelvic brim. Then if we come back here, let's turn it a little bit here, this right here is the auricular surface of the ilium. Now the auricular surface of the ilium is important because it articulates with the auricular surface of the sacrum to form the sacroiliac joint. Then if you look here, there's this little spine there. This is the posterior superior iliac spine. And this one is the posterior inferior iliac spine. And if you pretend I'm going down a roller coaster right here, this is the greater sciatic notch. This is the ischial spine. So now we're heading into the ischium now. So now we're in the ischium, guys. So if we turn over here, this is the lesser sciatic notch. Then we have the ischial tuberosity right there, that roughened surface. And then right here is the ramus of the ischium. There's a big hole right here. This is actually the obturator foramen. It's one of the biggest holes in the body. And if I come over here, now we're in pubis, guys. So this is the inferior ramus of the pubis, this part right here. This is the superior ramus of the pubis. And again, this is going to be the part of the, this is the articulating surface of the pubis. This is actually going to help to form the pubic symphysis joint, which has, again, those nice fibrocartilage packing between it. Now I'm going to kind of turn this up this way, guys. So this right here, this little bump, is called the pubic tubercle. That's the pubic tubercle right there. Then, if I kind of move this part right here, that is going to be called the pubic crest. So pubic tubercle and then pubic crest. Okay, now I'm going to kind of flip it on the outside here so we can see one more important thing. And again, this is called the acetabulum of the coxa bone. This is where the head of the femur articulates with it, all right, to form the synovial ball and socket joint. All right, if we come back up here to the ilium, this is actually going to be the posterior side of it. Our gluteal muscles, they sit right here on this part of the bone, okay? And so they call this the gluteal surface. Now you can't see it very well, probably not at all, but skeletal muscles are striated, so they form these lines too, and those are called gluteal lines. And that pretty much covers everything we need to know about the coxa bone. All right, guys, so now we're going to take a look at the whole pelvis. So if we look here, we have the two coxa bones here articulating with the sacrum. And if you know, that's going to help us. Again, this is the sacroiliac joint right there. So, and then this part right here in the front, this is the pubic symphysis. And that's actually going to be an amphiarthrotic joint. It's a cartilaginous joint made up of fibrocartilage. And again, this is going to be called, specifically it's called the symphysis joint, the pubic symphysis. All right, so if I take a look here and I actually move and make a circle all the way around right here, this is actually called the pelvic brim. And if you imagine putting a plate on top of that, anything above the plate or above the pelvic brim is actually referred to as false pelvis. And anything below the pelvic brim is true pelvis. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of pull this here back so we can take a look here. So if you look here, it looks like an arch, right? This is called the pubic arch. The pubic arch is good for us being able to tell whether this is a female or a male pelvis. As my professor said in the past, if it's broad, it's a broad. So this is a female pelvis because it's a very, very broad pubic arch. Okay? One more thing is if you look here, this is the pelvic inlet and this is the pelvic outlet. Or you can think about it as pelvic inlet is anything in part here. Pelvic outlet is anything past this point right there. All right, guys, that gives us everything we're going to need to know about the pelvis.